Good morning, dear children. Today we are starting new topic, that is the last topic of your course, that is sound wave, or simply wave motion. First we understand all general ideas of the wave, then we focus on the sound wave. Last time I told you to solve the assignment of SHM. I had sent you the solutions also. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay, also go through the NCRT, 5 or 6 questions from NCRT are very important. Even I have solved during the lecture. Okay, now before starting the sound wave, we need to understand what is general wave motion, dear children. Wave motion. Okay, so we can simply say a wave is a transfer of energy. A wave is a transfer of energy. Transfer of energy. Energy by oscillation. By oscillation of medium components. Of medium components. Okay, that is the main thing. Component means we have momentum as well as energy both. Wave has momentum and energy. Okay, dear children, what will happen? See, let this is the particle at the mean position. It get vibrated when you apply the force. And there is another neighboring particle. It will get the energy from this and it also get vibrated. Due to that, energy is transferred when there is a, wave formation. Okay, so energy is transferred, disturbance is transferred, that disturbance is called energy. But particle does not take part in the formation of wave. They only vibrate and produce the energy. Okay, so this is the meaning which you need to remember. And most important thing is that wave can carry energy and momentum along with them. So that is the main thing. Now, we can describe this wave in two types. One is called, dear children, mechanical wave. Even you did in the 9th standard this thing. Mechanical wave. And another is non-mechanical wave. Okay. In mechanical wave, dear children, basically it will require the particles. Okay? I can say the energy. It will require material medium for propagation. Okay. So energy transfer by oscillation of particles, your physical medium particle. Physical medium particles. Okay. For example, you have the sound wave here. Sound wave is the finest example of mechanical wave. Because sound requires material medium for the propagation, it will not travel in a vacuum. Because it will need the particles which will oscillate and produce the oscillation. And non-mechanical wave means energy transfer. Energy transfer take place by electric and magnetic field. Simply you can say electromagnetic wave. You know electromagnetic wave, gamma ray, X-ray, ultraviolet, visible, infrared, microwave or radio wave. These are called electromagnetic wave, or simply this is called light. Visible part of this is called light. I can say light is a non-mechanical wave, electromagnetic X-ray is a non-mechanical wave, radio wave is a non-mechanical wave. It will not require any medium particle, okay? So be careful about it. And mechanical wave, it will require the material medium, and non-mechanical wave, it will not require the material medium. For example, sound and light. Now, one more basic thing you need to remember. Wave generation. Wave generation. How wave is generated. That is the main thing, dear children. Suppose that this is the source of wave and it will produce the wave like this. Okay, and what is this, dear children? That is basically oscillation that we did in the SHM. This is called oscillation. Number of oscillations are there, and this small component is called pulse. Basic component of the wave is called pulse, and at time one period this is one oscillation and there is another oscillation. Group of oscillation will form the a wave. Okay, and medium particle, you can say medium particle act as wave carrier in this particular. Act as wave carrier. Okay. And whatever medium you are taking, especially for the sound wave, dear children, we need two property in that medium. One is inertia. Inertia means when you apply the force on the particle, okay, they should come back at the original position. Elasticity also, this is the second one. You already know this thing. Whenever this point is very, very important regarding the mechanical wave, okay, medium particle should have the elasticity and inertia, then only wave propagation will take place. But in case of the light, there is nothing is required, only electric field vectors are there. But we are here focusing on sound wave, that's why medium particle characteristics of a medium is very, very important. By this way, wave is generated. Now, before starting the actual syllabus topic, before that, I want to tell you basic things regarding the wave. First thing, I am talking about amplitude of the wave. Amplitude of the wave. I will denote it by, this is called amplitude. I already told you, dear children, if you have one oscillation like this, this is called amplitude. It may be plus A and it may be minus A. We did in SHM, what is amplitude? This is the maximum displacement of medium particle during oscillation from mean position. Okay. Let this is the mean position. This is the extreme position. Here X is equal to plus A. Here X is equal to minus A. You know, this is called mean position. So this is simply the amplitude. Okay. So ideal medium means, if there is an ideal medium, the two types of medium are there, dear children. I can say one is ideal medium. Ideal means where dissipation of energy is not take place. Energy loss will be zero. Okay, that's why amplitude will be constant throughout. And non-ideal, mostly we have non-ideal medium. Here we have dissipation of energy basically due to air friction, due to air drag, which is called viscosity. That's why amplitude of the wave will decrease continuously like this. If you have non-ideal medium, you have this situation. If you have ideal medium, you have this situation. Be careful about it. Now, next thing I need to explain here, that is frequency, time period, okay, all these facts. So let me tell you, second one is frequency of the wave. So frequency, I'll denote it by F. What is frequency? Number of oscillation of medium particle. You can say number of oscillations of medium particle. Number of oscillations of medium particles per unit time. Time. That is called frequency, dear children. Okay. Frequency is basically reciprocal of time period. You should remember it. Suppose that if you have one oscillation, just see over here. This is one oscillation. Time period is T. If you have two oscillation, time period is 2T. The frequency, what? Number of oscillation. If you have one oscillation, dear children, upon time period is T. If you have two oscillation, I can say two oscillation upon time period is 2T. 2-2 will cancel out. Every time you will get the 1 by T. That's why formula of frequency of wave is 1 upon T. Its unit is hertz, you know, in the junior sections also. Okay. So most important thing is that suppose that this is the medium 1 and this is medium 2. and wave is going from medium 1 to medium 2. What will happen? Frequency remains constant. It will not change because frequency is the characteristics of the source, not the medium. Rest of the parameters will change, wavelength will change, speed will change, okay? So both will change, but frequency remains constant. Be careful about it when sound goes from one medium to another. Yeah, next term which is important for you, that is wave velocity, dear children. All these things you did in the 9th standard also. Wave velocity, this is the basic idea. I am just recapitulating. Wave velocity, okay? So suppose that we have a wavelength, this is called wavelength, dear children. Okay, so horizontal distance, yeah, length of the one oscillation, that is called wavelength. Sometime these are supposed that crest and crest, separation between the crest is also called wavelength. But length of one oscillation is also called wavelength. If time is t till this and wavelength is lambda, then wave velocity I can say lambda upon t, that is length upon time. You know, 1 upon time is frequency, that's why it can be lambda into f. This is important relation you need to remember here. This is called wave velocity. Okay. But remember, its speed is decided by the medium particle because wavelength itself is inversely proportional to mu in light. Similarly, in case of the sound. But right now, you should remember only v is equal to lambda f. These are the things. One more thing you need to remember, dear children, here, that is types of mechanical wave. Types of mechanical wave. We have two types of mechanical wave. One is longitudinal wave. And another is transversal wave. You just understand it. In longitudinal wave, basically compression and rarefaction are formed. Compression, rarefaction. If you have a tuning fork like that and medium particle, suppose that medium particle has the concentration. When particles are very close to each other, compression is formed. And particles are far away from each other when they are oscillating from mean to extreme position. Rarefactions are formed. Then again, alternatively, compressions are formed, then rarefactions are formed by this way. You can denote it by this way also. Okay, these hills are called compression and these valleys are called rarefaction. Alright, and what will happen in longitudinal wave, dear children? Let's explain it. In longitudinal wave, basically, what will happen? The medium particle, these are supposed that particle. They get oscillation along the direction of the wave, like this. Vibration of the medium particle is along the direction of the wave and they will transfer the energy, which is called wave. So direction of the wave is also in same direction. Direction of propagation. Propagation means travel. Okay. What is longitudinal wave in which medium particle will vibrate along the direction of propagation? That is called longitudinal wave. For example, sound wave. In sound wave, basically, this thing will happen. Be careful about it. By the same manner, we will deal with the transversal wave also. So what is transversal wave? Let's see. In transversal wave, dear children, basically, medium particle will vibrate perpendicular to the direction of propagation. If this is the direction of propagation, and if you have a medium particle over here, and this is first medium particle, second, third, fourth, like that, they will vibrate perpendicular to the direction of propagation at every point. By this way. Okay. By this way, this will happen. Vibration of the particle is perpendicular to the direction of propagation. That is called what? That is called transversal wave. Okay. Here crust and trough are formed in case of the transversal wave. This is crust. This is trough. Okay. And for example, its example is light. Light wave is the example of transversal wave. Even some other thing, when you put the leaf on the water pond, okay? This is the leaf, and when you put the disturbance in the water, this leaf will move like that, and ripples will move like that. So that is also will form the transversal wave. Sometime string, when you put the string in a, I mean to say source, tie with a rigid support, this is a string. When you give the small jerk to it, it will form the wave like that. So that is called transversal wave in sum total. Okay, so be careful. This is very, very important for you, basic idea regarding the wave. So the one more thing you need to remember here, that is plane progressive wave. This is the new thing for you, plane progressive wave. Okay, plane progressive wave, dear children. Suppose that this is the source, and it has some amplitude and frequency. It is traveling by this way. Okay, and you can say medium is uniform. It has some amplitudes. It has some frequency. Okay, it is a wave, has constant amplitude and frequency and velocity also. It has some velocity. I can say the wave having constant amplitude, frequency, and velocity throughout. Throughout, that is called plane progressive wave. Be careful. And this type of the wave will follow simple all the particle will follow simple harmonic motion in the type of the wave. That's why sometime it is also called simple harmonic. Simple harmonic wave. You know, to explain the simple harmonic wave, we need sine theta and cos theta always. Okay, so it depends from where vibration will take place, from main or extreme position. According to that, we will use the sine theta and cos theta, just like the SHM, dear children. So be careful about it. Okay, if suppose that this plane progressive wave is formed somewhere, so it is the function of displacement and time. Be careful that this is the displacement, this is the function of displacement and time anywhere when it is moving like this. This is the plane progressive wave, and it has some velocity, and you know this is y, and it has displacement and time, both is the function here. Okay, as it is the vibration like that. Okay, this is plane progressive wave. You need to remember here general equation of plane progressive wave. No need to prove, only remember the result. Okay, the general equation of progressive wave, I can write y is equal to function of x minus vt, and another you can write y is equal to function of x is displacement and time, function of time and velocity. Okay, negative, this is positive. Negative means when it is moving along positive x-axis, then we will use negative sign here. When you are moving along negative x-axis, we will use negative x-axis, then we will use the positive sign here. Okay, so be careful about it. Along positive x-axis, x minus vt, along negative x-axis, we have here what? X plus vt. So be careful about it. Now, if you write generally simple harmonic wave for it, it will be a sine omega t minus kx. This is most popular equation. Or you can say a sine omega t minus plus kx. Till omega t, it was simple harmonic wave, but x is the displacement here. It was positive x-axis direction because it has the negative sign, and it is along negative x-axis direction, general equation of the plane progressive wave. What is k here, dear children? K is the angular wave number. एंगुलर वेव नंबर, इट्स वैल्यू यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट इज 2 पाई लैम्बडा, 2 पाई अपॉन लैम्बडा, बी केयरफुल. ओके, सो दिस जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ द प्लेन प्रोग्रेसिव वेव यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. यू कैन मॉडिफाई इवन फॉर द मोर सेटअप. लेट्स सी मॉडिफिकेशन ऑफ दिस वेव. आई कैन राइट वाई इज इक्वल टू ए साइन. If you take omega common, that will be t minus x upon v. Okay. Even you can modify further also. If a sine 2 pi by lambda, it will be vt minus x. One more modification will be there. A sine, if you take 2 pi common, that will be t upon capital T minus x upon lambda. So by the various way you can, I mean to say, modify this result, but most important result is this one, you should remember. Omega is here angular frequency, which can be written as 2 pi upon t, we already know this thing. Okay, and t is the time, x is the position. Position and time both are changing. That type of the wave is called a simple harmonic wave or plane progressive wave. It is progressed or in the state of motion in a one plane, that's what is called plane progressive wave. It has these parameters which will propose the plane progressive wave. And direction is also matters here, that is, if you have the positive side of x-axis, it will be a sine omega t minus kx. If it is a negative side, then it will be omega t plus kx. K is the angular wave number which will tell you how many waves are generated in per angle, that is 2 pi upon. The rest of the things I will explain main topic in the next lecture. Till that, all these basic things you have to keep in mind. Okay, thank you very much.